Dunn, city of Dunn in North Carolina. It's so good to have you guys here. And we're anxious to hear what you have to tell us about your communities. And so are you ready for your presentation?
We are ready!
Well, we're more than ready to hear it, so you may begin.
On behalf of Mayor Oscar Harris, who was recently hospitalized due to a serious accident, we are honored to be in Denver today. We are a small town with a small tax base, so we must leverage our resources. How do we do that?
Public-private partnerships!
That's what makes us different. We may be small, but we dream big. We care and we share. Many of our partners have traveled to Denver at their own expense to tell our story. Now let's hear from our partners.
I am the CEO of Harnett Health. The City of Dunn's partnership and leadership has transformed healthcare in Harnett County and made it a reality. You're going to hear about what's happened in people's lives right now, and it's been very positive.
When I chaired the County Commission, we partnered with the City of Dunn and Harnett Health in an investment of $63 million in order to provide much-needed healthcare services to our community.
I am a retired combat medic and police chief with Harnett Health. With the City of Dunn's support, we have hired 40 military veterans and 15 active duty spouses.
In 2012, we treated over 44,000 patients in our newly renovated emergency room. In fact, already this year, we've seen 25,000 patients.
To ensure all our patients receive quality, compassionate care, we provide more than $14 million each year in charity care, ranking us sixth in our state.
When the tornado of 2011 went through 6 miles of Dunn, 40 homes and 14 businesses were destroyed. Emergency services responded to 152 calls and injuries, and 2 lives were lost. Our community established a donation center serving over 13,000 meals and dedicating an excess of 16,400 volunteer hours.
Many of our citizens volunteer their time helping their neighbors. We have over 130 volunteers serving more than 22,400 hours each year.
From the cafeteria to now managing our customer service experience, I am pleased to say that my career has grown with Harnett Health. As a military widow of a Dunn native, the family-oriented community of Dunn continues to support me and my daughters.
Since August of last year, we've created 225 new jobs and brought in 113 medical providers as we continue to build a premier medical staff. In the next 10 years, we'll create more than 300 jobs and have a positive economic impact of $700 million.
As a current member of the Harnett Health Board of Trustees and a former Colonel, U.S. Army retired, I can truly say that this public-private partnership has transformed healthcare in our community for the better.
The City of Dunn's partnership has made the next expansion a reality, a second new hospital.
Harnett Health is saving lives, and together we are saving livelihoods. Dunn, United Dunn!
I chair the Downtown Dunn Development Corporation, and our recent ribbon cutting was a culmination of a 10-year project to make our downtown vision come true. Here's our story.
In 2003, the vision of a makeover began. New streetscapes, underground utilities, and replacing our 100-year-old infrastructure.
We then gained approval for downtown to be included in the National Registry of Historic Places.
The question for our small city, how to fund the $3.2 million project? The answer, public-private partnerships.
The downtown property owners decided that a tax district had to be formed. Low-interest loans were obtained.
Our group committed $100,000 for lighting and sound capabilities. We have committed $35,000 annually to assist the city in debt service.
Another challenge was parking. A local business donated property for a new downtown parking area. Another example of public-private partnership.
Property owners caught the vision and began to make improvements to their storefronts. Facade grants and incentives were made available, and to date, $75,000 tax dollars have been reinvested.
It took 10 years for our vision to become a reality, but we did it, the rebirth of downtown Dunn.
Celebrating in our success are many new downtown businesses, but we're equally proud of our heritage. Sherry's Bakery, the sweetest smelling corner in town for 40 years. First Citizens Bank, 89 years and a $4 million investment. And celebrating 125 years, Jordan's Jewelry.
Our city center is alive and well with events such as
Hornet Regional Theater,
annual lighting of the Christmas tree and parade with entertainment for the local schools,
Cotton Festival brings thousands to downtown,
and our concert series, Boogie on Broad.
We are proud of our success and equally proud about our future. 10 years ago, we didn't want to be just another city on I-95, but instead, we've become a community on 95 with a rich and vibrant downtown.
It's all done!
Who are we?
Cops!
Kids!
Community! Working together!
In 1995, the Dunn Police Department started to see an increase in juvenile crime.
We needed to bring Dunn's youth, police, and the community together. The Dunn Police Athletic Activities League, nationally known as PAL, was born.
PAL started with just 10 youth and only one program. It has evolved into over 300 youth and more than 8 programs.
PAL is open to youth ages 6 to 18 of Dunn and surrounding communities. It gives us a place to belong.
PAL provides positive alternatives through sports, education, and community service programs.
I am a graduate AC and have been in PAL for 9 years. Lieutenant Rowland encourages us, checks on our grades, and encourages us to go to college.
As PAL moved quickly in our area, our students became productive citizens.
The after-school programs have helped me become a better student and public speaker.
It's only at people who care about our future, our teachers and volunteers about our life and activities.
PAL is a safe haven with a mission to help our youth. The Youth Leadership Council develops leadership skills, as you're witnessing today.
I was in PAL for over 5 years. I played sports and my grades improved. PAL gave me a chance to give back to my community by working with our mobile food pantry, and I just finished my first year of college.
Sports brought them in, but lives have been strengthened through mentoring, tutoring, and enrichment programs.
I'm a recent graduate of Boys Town, Nebraska, because of PAL. We're going to college.
Our program works. Evidenced by 2,478 members, 1,018 high school graduates, 629 attended college, 45 attended Boys Town, 15 entered Jobs Corps.
PAL thrives on public-private partnerships. Churches, state, county, and local governments, schools, law enforcement, and National PAL.
Volunteers have given over 200,000 hours. PAL has received in excess of $1.6 million in grant funds and over $400,000 in local contributions and fundraisers since 1995.
Our youth have a working greenhouse to grow plants and produce. We use them in our culinary arts program and for the beautification of Dunn.
PAL gave me my first real job as a lifeguard. I am a graduate of North Carolina A&T State University. I am a commissioned officer in the United States Army, serving as a registered nurse at the rank of captain. 35 youth have enlisted into the military. Army strong!
I serve on the PAL Advisory Board as one of the 13 community volunteers. The board has given out approximately $20,000 in scholarships to our deserving youth. The PAL has impacted generations. I was a PAL member, and now my son is a PAL member.
I competed in New Way Nationals, and I run a spot on the All-American Wrestling Team.
We believe that PAL is the best.
Cops, kids, community, working together.
That's not all Dunn has to be proud of. There's a lot more. We know, for instance, that our schools face many challenges. One answer is the Leader in Me at the primary and the elementary schools that we have implemented. Harnett Primary is only the second in the state and the 44th in the world to achieve lighthouse status.
The seven habits of the Leader in Me are: be proactive, begin with the end in mind, Put first things first, think win-win, seek first to understand, then to be understood, synergize, and sharpen the saw.
Our business incubator partners with the local community college to provide resources to create to businesses to create and save jobs. 133 businesses incubated, 2,400 jobs, 110 loans, $12 million, 1,700 jobs.
Partnerships for Improved Recreation, a $2 million park renovation project with $1.3 million in private donations.
Phase one complete!
Phase two will include a miracle field and Armed Forces Memorial.
Complete a $1.2 million recreation center with $600,000 in private donations.
We are not just proud to be Dunn, we are proud to be Americans.
Dunn, home of General William C. Lee, father of the airborne. Our Airborne Museum honors his great accomplishments, and as a retired airborne major, I know all about that, having jumped into Panama with the 82nd Airborne.
A local businessman annually sponsors an overnight trip to Washington, D.C., allowing 75 World War II veterans, along with other veterans, to visit memorials honoring them.
Three American Legion members have attained the rank of North Carolina State Commander.
Our veterans organization partnered with Habitat to build a home for a veteran.
We are proud to have veterans employed in our community and proud to have them in some of our top positions of leadership, including our mayor, who is a Marine. Airborne!
Proud to fly American flags in Dunn.
As you can see, our community believes in partnerships, and we know that
working together works!
Impressive group of people from a community that's what, 6,000? 6,200? Something like that?
9,200.
Anyway, thank you for being here. I know that you have so much going on. I know this panel is going to want to ask you some questions. So I believe Kurt's going to start us.
I asked for the microphone about halfway through your presentation. Very impressed with your PAL program and the creativity that you've utilized. So I have a couple of questions. Number one, how did you decide, or I don't even know who to direct this to, but how did you decide to work with Boys Town in Nebraska? That's question number one, and kind of 1A, I don't know how long you've been doing that, but have you seen the grads from Boys Town come back to your community as productive citizens, investing back in the community? So, I'm impressed with that creativity. I'd like to know how it happened, and are you seeing any results from it?
Actually, believe it or not, our connection with Boys Town started over an email back in 2003. The young man that's there now is the coordinator that gets youth to come in through athletics, and he had been trying to work a partnership with National PAL, and he sent out the email. We responded back and didn't have the description that he was looking for at the time fit one young man that we had that was at the local high school. So I responded back with what we had. That's how it got started. We've since sent several to Boys Town. They have all, well, most of them has completed successfully, come back to the community, and either in college or in working in our community. And we have one here with us today.
Hey, yes, I'm one of the students that went to Boys Town, and it's a blessing to be there because Boys Town saved my life, and I want to thank Lieutenant Rowley for sending me there. But basically, Boys Town is a family-oriented place, so basically you do everything with your family. It teaches respect, how to be respect others, time management, be on time, and make it bad. Just simple, basic rules in life that you have to follow. That's what I'm
doing. Thank you for your question. Many times we have seen young people that needed to be taken out of communities and with community support behind them. This young man right here is certainly one of our best examples.
Yes.
Of being in a place that he could concentrate on what he needed to do. However, The Dunn community has wrapped their services, their love, and their love of community around him in a public-private partnership of getting it all done. So we're very proud of him.
You're all on I-95, right?
Yes, sir.
Just south of Raleigh?
Yes.
Okay. And I say that because every once in a while I'm down in that area on vacation. Someone was talking about economic development and said something about a public-private partnership functioning in the economic development area. That wasn't clear to me.
Yes, sir. Public-private partnerships are an important part of what we do for a couple of reasons. It allows everybody to bring the best they got to the table. I was a county commissioner, and local governments do things, some things really well. They do water and sewer, roads. They can coordinate for economic development grants and services, and coordinate with higher levels of government. So when you combine that with the private sector, who brings the people and the ideas and the innovation, and you put all that together, you can have something really positive. One thing in our community is really positive is the Harnett Health System that we've developed as a public-private partnership. We have a brand new hospital, and we have health care that is available to about 100,000 residents of Harnett County that wasn't available a few years ago. The key takeaway to that is that without the investment of the city of Dunn with their original hospital into that, we wouldn't have been able to create the Harnett Health System. It was tough for them to do, but it was an incredible investment and a courageous investment. And thanks to their vision and their investment of their assets, Harnett Health has created. And so not only have they helped themselves, they've helped others. So we're real proud of that.
As a follow-up to that, and I'll come back to the hospital point in a moment, but just some of the projects that would not have gotten off the ground without the public-private partnership. One that comes to mind was when I was mayor, we were trying to do a pretty aggressive new recreation center. We did obtain a grant through our program in Raleigh. The city did have some money to put into the game, but quite honestly, we did not have enough money at the time to do it, but we were in desperate need of new facilities. So we raised $600,000 in pledges and got that building built and cut the ribbon on that. Now, just recently, this summer, the same thing happened, but the numbers are much greater. It was a $3 million project. Again, we got $500,000 from Raleigh. We got about $1.5 million from the city council, but we were about $1 million short. The citizens of Dunn stepped up, pledged the money, the loans were taken, and the ribbon cutting on our new athletic facility was done in time for this year's summer baseball league.
When you borrow that $1 million, do you get an interest on it? Do they get an interest on it? Or?
No, sir. That's pledges from individuals that will be paid over a period of time, but enables us to go ahead and get the money to get it done.
And as far as economic development, Teddy Bird was also instrumental in getting the Harnett Ford Together committee established for our county, and they recruit industry for our entire county, and it brings us all together, so we're all working for the good of not just Dunn, but the entire county.
Jerry, I believe you have a question.
Thank you, Sharon. You know, I'm struck by a community of 9,000 people having a delegation of 8,000 people. So congratulations. I mean, I think that it says a lot. What I understand is 10 years ago, you decided you needed to change course a little bit and do things maybe a little differently. At least that's what I'm taking away here. And you've been at it for 10 years, and you've entered this in very different ways and different venues. What caused that to happen, and what caused you to be able to maintain 10 years of direction and energy?
Well, it's funny. 10 years ago, we thought we were in a pretty good place at the time, but you look around you and see some gaps in what you want to do, the PAL program being one of them. Healthcare, which we're extremely proud of, which I'll touch on in a minute, and of course our downtown revitalization project. We were very, very fortunate, unlike a lot of cities and towns in eastern North Carolina that when tobacco left or cotton left, a lot of those towns just really got boarded up to the point they never can come back, which is quite unfortunate. For us, we were not at that point, but we were getting close to the point where we had a few more boards in our downtown than we really wanted. And of course, all the big box stores had exited to go out to the suburbs. So that's about the point in time, actually it was 2002, as a result of a Chamber of Commerce, believe it or not, image and beautification committee meeting that met one morning at Sherry's Bakery that says, we think we can do better. And as a result of that Chamber of Commerce committee not being proud of our downtown, the Dunn Downtown Development Corporation was born. The city council at that time got on board. The tax district was formed, and the rest is history. We cut the ribbon on that project about 60 days ago, and it was a project that quite honestly, over a period of about 30 or 40 years, some people had tried and just couldn't get the momentum going. But we were at a point where we just could not turn back, and everybody came together to make that happen.
I'm with the Chamber of Commerce, and I just want to say I'm so proud to be a part of a community that when we see a challenge and we see a problem, we get busy. And we haven't conquered all our challenges, but we've not finished yet. And we might be back again because we're going to keep working until we get it all right.
That's right.
Let me ask you, first of all, you are to be commended, your application, your enthusiasm. But I'm very interested in your Triangle South Enterprise Center, because it's been in existence for 25 years, and incubators are kind of like the new trendy thing. You've been doing it for 25 years. What's that extra magic that you've lent to this program that has allowed it to be so successful?
A lot of it is partnerships. Our primary partnership is with Central Carolina Community College. Secondary partnership is with Harnett County. The county of Harnett actually owns the building. And so with all our service providers and people that we partner with and the interest that the community has taken in this project, then it's helped it become successful.
I just have one more trailing question.
Sure.
You've launched 133 businesses.
That is.
So I want to ask a question. Do you continue to monitor those businesses and support them?
Our first contract with our funding for the incubator came from the North Carolina Technological Development Authority. And they require that we report quarterly on businesses and number of jobs created. And so we've always kept that database. We also lend money through USDA. And they require also that we track jobs and, you know, all the money that's lent. Unfortunately, through the community college, we did not have a really good tracking system in the early years. We do now, so everything's monitored.
City of Dunn, I have to thank you for being here. And Terry's right, I think. Good portion of the town is here. So that's good. Are all of you nurses that have on the green scrubs?
No.
Oh, well, then I don't feel as sick as I thought I did. I thought I was in great care today. And then I began to think, if he's a doctor in your town, you're pretty amazing. You're a young one. You just have so many wonderful things to tell. And I told the men in the city as I walked in and gone to the bathroom and came back, they had hard hats on, and I said, that's what we wore when we came in 2005, so that brought back a lot of good memories. You have every reason to be extremely proud of your community and who you are as individuals and young people that are making a difference in your lives. There's nothing we can say except we're proud of you. Keep up the good work, and D-U-N-N is better than maybe the YMCA. Thank you for being here. Thank you for sharing your story.
Thank you, George. Thank you, George. We're done.
Here we go! And now if we could have Mr. Hugh Guest, former board member of NCL, come forward to announce the 9th All-America City Award.
I've been doing this since 1992. I started out because Allstate Insurance Company asked me to participate on a small committee for them. And I ask a lot of you all about I-95. Are you on I-95? I've also been on I-50, I-75, I-1. I had a job that I did for Congress where we had 7 district offices and 174 nonprofits across this country. And my job was to see about that network. So I know about a lot of your communities. I've been in them, out of them, run out of them. I-95 runs about a half a mile from my house. So if you're coming north and you come into Maryland, you come by exit 12 on I-95 in Maryland, honk your horn. I might hear you. This community took a bold approach to health care. This community has transformed its downtown. This community invests in its youth. This community is not on I-95, but it's close. The All-American City of Dunn, North Carolina.
Thank you.
I just want to say, I think all of you know that Dunn, North Carolina is here. And we are extremely grateful to you, George. We have had a wonderful time. We are without our mayor, and so a while ago when our speaker was speaking, we are FaceTiming him with his grandson over here. So everybody wave. Our mayor was injured in a serious accident on Saturday before we flew out on Wednesday. He has truly been our cheerleader. 2 days after we got here, we lost two of our delegates to very critical situations, one that is still very critical. So we cannot tell you how hard it was as we started out. But I think, as you know, we have put on our best face forward, as all communities do. And we have done our best. So thank you. And we love you all. Thanks.